If you've ever wondered, hey, how do I pick a folder with .NET MAUI, then this video is for you. I have told you on many occasions how amazing the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit is, and not just because I'm involved with, you know, contributing to it. In fact, I love it so much that there is a dedicated playlist, which should pop up on your screen right now or find it down below, that you can watch with all kinds of videos about the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit. And in this video, we're going to talk about the folder picker that was recently added at the time this video was recorded. So with the folder picker, you can basically go out, spawn a little dialogue on each platform, Windows, iOS, Android, macOS, Tizen, and that allows you to pick a folder. So not a file, we have the file picker already in .NET MAUI, but that allows you to pick files, right? But sometimes you need to pick a folder. So in this video, we're going to explore the folder picker in the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit. Let's hop over to Visual Studio. Here in Visual Studio 2022, I just created a file, new .NET MAUI project. You can find the code in my GitHub repository. All my videos have a GitHub repository attached, so find it down below in the video description. And the first thing that we want to do, you've seen me do it many times, but I'm just going to do it one more time, is install the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit. So go to our Solution Explorer, right-click on the project, do Manage NuGet Packages, and then on the Browse tab, make sure to search for CommunityToolkit.MAUI. And whenever the search stops loading, we can now find the CommunityToolkit.MAUI, and we got a couple more. We got the core package, we got the markup package, which does amazing things. We have the media element now, which is crazy, crazy cool, but we just want to stick with CommunityToolkit.MAUI. So let's install that. Version 4.0 at the time of recording, so you probably want to make sure to have at least that version. And whenever we do, we get this little readme that's going to help us. And the thing that you want to remember from this, or probably want to copy and paste from this, is this use MAUI Community Toolkit line. I'm going to copy that and go over to my MAUI program.cs. So let's go to the Solution Explorer, MAUI program.cs, and go paste that line in here in my app builder. Now, there might be other stuff in here for your real world application, but just make sure that it's somewhere hooked up to your builder variable instance right here. So use MAUI Community Toolkit, and that will add this using CommunityToolkit.MAUI here at the top. Make sure that you have that, and everything is wired now to use the Community Toolkit features. So let's go over to the mainpage.xaml. I'm just going to, you know, add a little thing right here. So I already have a couple of labels. Let's add actually this label. I'm going to add an X name here so I can reference it from the code behind, and I'm going to name this folder path. So the hello world is going to be replaced with whatever I pick as a folder. And then in the mainpage.xaml.cs, I'm going to implement some code. So I'm just going to remove this counter button click stuff actually, and remove this count variable just to clean it up here a little bit. And what I can now say is folder picker, and you will have to import the right using for this. So let's wait for IntelliSets to help us. Click on the light bulb using CommunityToolkit.MAUI.storage. So let's just pop that in there. You can also type that yourself here and it will help. And then you can do folder picker dot. And we got a couple of options. We have the default. So that's the default instance. This kind of like mimics the APIs that are inside of .NET MAUI directly, with like the file picker and the geolocation and media picker and all the kind of stuff. You have like the default instance that you can go out to, or we just have this static method of pick async. So with this default, and it's all, you know, it implements the I folder picker interface as well. So you can also register it for dependency injection. So you can use it like that as well, but I'm just going to use the static instance for now. So you have options here depending on what you want and need in your application. So let's just do the pick async, and then also you got a couple of overloads. So we have the cancellation token, and with the cancellation token, if you don't know what that is, actually maybe I should make a video about it. Let me know if that's something that is of interest to you. You can kind of like cancel the operation programmatically, right? So maybe you have a timeout, I don't know, seems kind of funny, but maybe you have a timeout in which the user has to pick a folder, and if 10 seconds have passed, then you want to cancel the folder picker dialog. So you just create a new cancellation token, do cancellation token.cancel or something like that, and the folder picker will disappear again automatically. So that's all stuff that you can do with this cancellation token. And we have an overload for the initial path. Now, the initial path is not implemented for each platform. I think right now it's only implemented for macOS, iOS, and Tizen, which kind of like opens the dialogue with the initial path, right? I think at least for Windows, it's not really possible to have an initial path. At least not a custom one. You have a couple of predefined ones on Windows. So I'm not sure. Maybe we're going to change something here a little bit. But at least for now, be aware that this might not always work on every platform. Else, you can plop a path in here and the folder picker will open with that path already shown. Now, in any case, it will return a folder object which has a couple of things. We'll see that in a little bit. And I'm going to go with the cancellation token one, and I'm not really going to use the cancellation token, so I'll just put default in here, which basically does new cancellation token, and I'm not really going to use it anyway. So var folder is this, and I probably want to make this async and then await this so that we do the async await stuff, and then I have the folder path dot text is folder dot name. Sounds good. But let's see what this folder actually does, right? Because this is the folder object. So what does it have more? It has a name. It also has a path. So that probably gets you the full path. So this might be the name. So actually, maybe we want to do a little string format here. And we want to do folder.name. Let's just get it all in here. And we also want to have, so let's add the name in here. And then we want to do path. There we go. And then we can do folder.path. We can see that as well. Does the folder have anything other useful things? I think so. There's also the deconstruct. So that's kind of like you will get the path and the name as two separate things. You can do that with this method to deconstruct, and you get the path in the out variable and the name as well. It's probably useful in some scenarios for you, but right now this should be enough. There is one other thing that is good to know, that is whenever the user cancels this dialog, it will throw an exception. So you have to put this in a try catch block. Well, you don't have to. I'm not here to tell you what you should do, but you probably want to, right? Because if it's going to be an unhandled exception, it's going to crash your application, which is probably not what you want. So here we have the try, and then whenever, you know, the user cancels or they somehow pick a folder that doesn't exist anymore or anything happens, you can do a little validation here in the catch. I'm not going to do anything but to do implement. That's how we fix these things, right? To do implement. So we got that all in place. And now I can actually start running the application. And when I press the button, it will bring up the Windows Picker dialog and it will allow me to pick a folder. So I'm going to click here and it's going to show me, it's going to open on my C drive and I can pick this program files one. So select folder. And you can see it updates name program files, right? So that's just the name of the folder that we've picked. And the full path is then going to be C program files. And I can click again. And I can go into this Intel one and I can select folder. And I think the Windows folder dialog, maybe other platforms do as well. They kind of like remember where you were, right? So you have this Intel and it remembers now that path. So that's kind of like how that works. And if I would run the same thing on Android and iOS and Tizen and all those things, I would get a dialog that allows me to pick a folder as well. So that is how easy it is to pick a folder now in .NET MAUI with the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit. So of course, this is just showing you how to pick the folder. Now from here, you can, I don't know, show all the files that are in that folder. You can, but of course, if the OS allows for it, right? Because on Windows, the access to the file system is pretty straightforward and you can now just go and iterate over all the files there. On Android or iOS, it might not be that simple. Also for Android, I know that you have to add permissions for if you want to access the external storage. I've put that in the code in the GitHub repository. And of course, there's also documentation for the folder picker as well. So go check out those links down in the video description below. Thank you again for watching one of my videos, and please don't forget to like it so that it will spread out to more people. I would very much appreciate that. Thank you so much. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. And oh, before you go, check out this playlist. Maybe you have some more time and check out more .NET MAUI videos, or check out this playlist for videos specific to the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit. See you for the next one.